everyone. My name is Courtney and I'm a witch. And on today's episode of The Witch Diaries, we're going to be talking about familiars. So what are familiars? Why is it that witches are associated with black cats? And how do you call in a familiar if you're ready for one? So familiars can sometimes actually be humans that have taken on the form of an animal. So taking on an animal incarnation in order to help the witch. They could also be just an animal who's normally an animal, but steps forward to help the witch. I have this whole, you know, especially now with how much the energies on the planet are changing, I think a lot of people have heard of the term star seeds. Probably a lot of people watching this are star seeds. I have actually seen animals recently, within maybe the last 5 or 10 years, who are actually what I keep referring to as star animals, and they're animals that are much more evolved and advanced and sort of conscious than the other animals in their species, and you can really see a difference in them. For instance, my dog, who I don't know if I'd exactly say she ended up being my familiar, but there was this really strong relationship with her. She was definitely what I always called a star animal. She was so much more intelligent than other dogs. She wasn't really interested in the things other dogs were. So like, if I would try to play fetch with her, like I would throw the ball and then she would just like look at it, see that I threw it. Then she'd look up at me like, are you crazy? Like, I'm not gonna go get that. And then she'd just walk away. So I could never do like normal dog human activities with her because she like was not interested. And she would do things like, she would like play pranks on me and like, you know, she was so different than the dogs at the park, and a lot of the dogs didn't like her. But then I found that star children like loved her, and they would come to my house and bring her presents and like throw her birthday parties, and like, you know, she was just very different than any other dogs that I've really met. And so I've seen this with other animals where they're like, especially because of, I guess, how much everything's changing on this planet, they're like more evolved and more conscious, and they're more aware of what's going on. They're very different than the other animals. So I think especially with all of that, it's entirely possible that you call in a familiar and it's a cat who's an incarnation, you know, that's always been a cat, but they're like a star cat. They're like just very different. And an animal like that, I think, really likes magic and really likes all this stuff. So that's also possible that happens. There's also another idea around familiars, that a lot of it may have come from witches who were also shapeshifters, and they would actually just shapeshift into cats. So in that case, I guess you'd be your own familiar. And so maybe if there's people who are watching this who are shapeshifters, you know, that could be one thing. I've been learning a lot more about shapeshifting, and it seems that some people just have a hereditary connection to shapeshifting, so it can run in families. And there's also a variety of shapeshifters. Most aren't actually able to turn into the cat or into the dog or the wolf or whatever it is, but more so are just strongly connected to that animal and can tap into that energy, into that way of thinking, into sort of how they see those animals see the world. So I think, so interesting enough, like when I was doing research for this, and I was kind of wondering why people got the association of witches with black cats, and there's all this fear, and there's I was getting a lot of stories about, you know, in the 1500s or the Middle Ages, that there would be reports of women who are suspected of witchcraft, and then people seeing them turn into a black cat, or seeing a cat enter their home or enter into other people's homes and causing problems or even killing people. And so I think, especially because these stories come from back in the day, I think it's possible some of these women actually were shapeshifters who actually were shifting into cats. And that's basically what a lot of these stories were saying. Like eyewitness accounts of people seeing a cat and then them following the cat and it turned into a woman, or them throwing rocks at the cat and the cat's foot gets injured, and the next day this woman they suspected being a witch, her foot is injured, in the same way the cat was. So, and I think there's also so I think there's also the, from a witch's perspective, cats really are the embodiment of the divine feminine. Cats are seen as having supernatural powers anyways, and seen as being really mysterious. And in terms of black cats, black, represents the night, it represents the dark goddess. It represents a lot of the things as witches were drawn towards anyways. And at different points in history, they've been seen as, black cats have actually been seen as good luck. In the US, they're currently still seen as bad luck, to the point where it's really hard for black cats and even black dogs to get adopted. So they tend to be put to sleep at much higher rates because there is this fear around them. And there's also this belief they're evil or something like that. And a lot of that is stemming from Christianity and from Christian beliefs that were really being pushed when they were trying to, kill off all anyone suspected of being a witch. At that time, they would also burn cats at the stake. So not just witches were being burned, but they would burn their animals or animals they suspected of being familiars. I watched this one show that was sort of talking about that, and that one involved even, like, I believe it was it a chicken that they actually burned at the stake because it wasn't behaving. I'm not even joking. It was not behaving the way they thought that it should behave, so they suspected it was like possessed or like a witch or like something like that. They burned it at the stake. I mean, this is like, but this is how people were at that time. When I looked up the definition of familiar, I got one definition being a demon attending or obeying a witch, often said to often said that they help the witch and they take on the form of an animal. So, another definition was a demon or a fairy. So there is this belief that, yeah, that which that witches are were already being seen as evil, and then anyone around them or that could be assisting them. And I guess because cats are also seen as powerful and also seen as they are the representation of the feminine energy, so they kind of just unfortunately got associated with all that stuff and ended up suffering the repercussions of it. And one thing that happened is they started killing so many cats during the Middle Ages because they thought they were evil. It's actually one of the reasons that they had the plague to begin with, and they had other illnesses because they killed so many cats that the rodent population just exploded. Which is really interesting because if you look at at cats, how they were seen in ancient Egypt, they were actually seen as, they were being seen as sacred, as something to worship. It was a capital crime to kill them. And part of the reason they were so revered is because cats did kill rodents, which meant that there weren't all these diseases, and it also protected a lot of their food supply from being eaten by by rats. So it's just interesting to see the difference where people were seeing how beneficial cats were, and then you have over here, they see them as evil, so they start killing them, and then they start dying from these diseases that the cats were protecting them from. So there's also a belief that witches could transform into a black cat. They would have, the witch would have 9 lives, which is where it could be associated with why cats have 9 lives. You see this, a good representation of this is on the show Witches of East End. One of the characters has 9 lives and she transforms into a black cat. So if you haven't seen that show, definitely check it out. So familiars are believed to exist in both the spirit world and the human world, and they were seen as the gatekeepers for witches. I was definitely reading about reports of cats like almost like the familiar just using her consciousness to shapeshift into the cat. So she wasn't actually turning into a cat, but she was just connecting to the cat, and then the cat would go on these adventures, so she would experience that through the cat of like, sort of flying through the air and like jumping or falling or all these things. And it's interesting when you think about this idea that witches can fly and the association they had with cats who sort of can fly, or at least they like to jump off of things. So, and as far as calling in a familiar, this will really happen when it's the right time. We're gonna do a little just ceremony to call in one, but it might happen right away. It might not happen for a long time. It will happen when it's right for you, and right for the familiar as well. And I do just want to put it out there, well, I think most of these familiars will show up in the form of a cat and probably a black cat. It is entirely possible it could show up in the form of almost any other animal, especially if there's maybe you don't have a strong connection to cats, but you have a strong connection to dogs or possibly anything else. It's entirely possible it shows up in that form. I think the one thing is, as someone who likes to really watch videos of animals and their humans, I have seen some crazy relationships between a human and an animal you would not expect, like a chicken or something, or like a cow, or just, there is one of a bull that was saved from bullfighting, and just like the connection these people had to that particular animal was crazy. I mean, I know those people aren't witches, but that it was so strong, the bond between them and this animal. It's almost unbelievable to see that, because you think of that with only people and dogs, or maybe people and cats, but you don't think of it with a person and a chicken, or a person and a farm animal, or anything else. So it could really, your familiar might be something smaller, like a rabbit or a guinea pig. It could be anything. So it could be a bird. Birds are usually, seen as messengers between here and God, and a sign from angels. So that could be, it could just be anything. So I just want to put that out there, because you might be like waiting for your black cat, and then suddenly, you're really into like helping out at a farm sanctuary, and you have this like strong connection to a cow, and you're like, what's going on here? Like I've said, I've never actually seen that before, but I think there's a first time for everything, and just to stay open to that possibility. So, you know, your familiar will show up in the form that is right for you and for where you're at in terms of learning and what you need to learn, and will help you grow as both a witch and a person. So it could be in the form of a farm animal if you're needing that stronger connection. I mean, it could be anything. They are your teacher. So now we're gonna call in the goddess Bass, and we're gonna ask her to help us with our familiar, finding our familiar. So Bass is an ancient Egyptian goddess. I have this absolutely beautiful handmade candle that was created just for her, and it has some information on the back about her, which I wanted to share with all of you. So it says, Bass is an ancient cat goddess, solar goddess, war goddess, and divine mother who has been worshipped since the second dynasty in Lower Egypt. Originally, she was viewed as the protector goddess of Lower Egypt and consequently depicted as a fierce lioness. Indeed, her name means female devourer. As protector, she was seen as defender of the pharaoh and consequently of the later chief male deity, Ra. She was a solar deity also, gaining her the titles Lady of Flame and Eye of Ra. Later, Bass came to be called Basset. Since Basset literally meant female of the ointment jar, Bass gradually became regarded as the goddess of perfumes, earning the title Perfume Protector. In connection with this, when Anubis became the god of embalming, Bass, as goddess of ointment, came to be regarded as his wife. Bass brings the art of playfulness, joy, and humor. She is the protector of mothers and newborns and the goddess of sorcery, beneficence, joy, dance, and fertility. And also a fun fact about her, when her temple was excavated, they found her buried with 300,000 cats. Yes, 300,000. So as I light this candle, we not only pay homage to Bass and everything she stands for, but we also ask her to help us with our journey of meeting and connecting with our familiar. And if we already have a familiar, we use this as an opportunity to honor our familiar and everything they've done for us. And we use this as an opportunity to honor animals in general and everything that the animal kingdom has given us. And we ask that when the time is right, that our familiar comes into our life. And that we are guided, if we're meant to go out and find our familiar, that we're guided to where we're supposed to go to find them. So, as all this energy is grounded, we thank Bass for being a part of this. We thank all the cats on this planet for being our companions, for everything they've done for us as witches. We thank all the animals for everything they've done for us. We honor them. And we look forward to having a stronger connection with the animal kingdom and with knowing what they need from us as humans in order to help them on this planet at this time. And we see our familiars coming into our life at the perfect timing. we see ourselves going on a very magical journey with them. So thank you so much for watching this video. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. I will be having more videos shortly. Thank you so much.